4.6 billion years since its creation, the Earth has continued to surprise us with its natural wonders. Today, we will journey to a sea just below the equator, home to so many creatures. This sea is referred to as the Miracle Sea by divers everywhere, and is the world's most spectacular coral paradise. More than 1,300 species of fish fill these waters. What is the real source of this miraculous beauty?
If you listen, try it.
Listen.
Mm-hmm. You can hear the...
A mysterious current gushes up from the deep waters. The wonderful mechanism behind this will be revealed. The crew will attempt to film the symbol of these rich seas, the giant manta ray. Today's destination is the Equatorial Republic of Indonesia. Its Raja Ampat diving area is located near the tip of the island of New Guinea. Divers throughout the world all dream of visiting this area and call it the Miracle Sea. But what is the miracle that they refer to? Underwater cameramen made over 40 dives to try to solve this mystery.
Well, I mean, you probably already know about the diversity of the coral species. So many, many, many kinds of soft coral and hard coral, and very, very diverse. Well, record-breaking for the diversity, and also for the fish species. So many kinds of fish, so many kinds of coral. This is what's special.
Raja Ampat is spread over 600 islands of varying size. This includes Waigeo Island in the north and Misul Island in the south. And there are more than 100 dive sites here.
It's gonna get less.
First, our divers descend to a coral site that is considered to be one of the best in the world. This sea has coral that is even more spectacular than the coral of Australia's Great Barrier Reef and the seas near Ishigaki Island in Japan. Let's enter this amazing world.
I'm swimming 5 meters at the bottom, but I don't have any feet. The sand is growing. Normally, 同じ種類のサンゴが群生するのをよく見るんですけれども、これだけ様々なサンゴを見るのは初めてかもしれないですね。なんかサンゴ畑を宇宙遊泳してる気分になりますね。 見てください、これ。すごい模様が入ってるように見えますよね。ノウサンゴの仲間だと思います。面白い形のサンゴを発見しました。沖縄でよく見かけるキャベツコーラルっていうサンゴに 似てるんですけれども、これやけに大きいですね。広べたい板がたくさんある感じです。
These are hard coral with a hard, chalky skeleton. It's an amazing fact that in Raja Ampat, two-thirds of the world's coral, which is over 550 types, have been found. We dive down a bit deeper. Now at a depth of 15 meters. The sea looks really different here. Soft coral sways around in the current. Most soft coral doesn't use photosynthesis. Because of this, it can grow in fairly deep places and in the shadow of boulders. The film crew switches cameras. They also want to shoot the other creatures that live in the world's most amazing coral field. Oh, something is moving. It's a tiny pygmy seahorse, only 1 centimeter long. It hides itself by mimicking its soft coral perch and really blends in. Now a sea slug appears. It's about 5 centimeters long. They're so pretty, they're called the jewels of the sea. This is also a sea slug. It looks like a colorful cartoon character. Next, a flashing shellfish is found. It's called a noble file clam. This sea has the world's most amazing coral. It really is like a paradise for both hard and soft coral. But this miracle sea holds even more surprises. Amazingly, this sea is also home to more than 1,300 types of fish.
Famous for the big fish action. Okay. So what we see on Cape Cree, we see schooling.
What kind of surprising world is it?
It's the big one with the yellow tail.
The underwater film crew takes on a big challenge. They'll try to film as many types of fish as possible during a one-hour dive.
So Mr. Osada, he dive here, here, and then around the back.
Okay,
good luck. For sure, it's a hard job, yeah?
However, all this tough underwater activity uses a lot of air from their tanks, so there is less time spent underwater. To make up for this, they'll film a variety of fish that appear within a small area. In the end, how many kinds of fish did the crew manage to film? They check the video to find out. They count them one by one while watching the monitor. They make sure that the same fish are not counted twice. These are some of the fish the crew filmed in the miracle. A saddleback butterfly fish. These mild-mannered fish can be found everywhere in these tropical seas. With the long, narrow face is a foxfish. The yellow and black one is a black-saddled coral grouper. Just 1 hour of diving. An endless variety of fish were captured on video.
I count the pieces.
Yeah.
What is how many?
How many? Oh, I don't know. 60 maybe.
100? 100? 100? 100? 100? これ新しいっていうさっきの被ってないというので 122やり122
wow.
One dive.
One dive. Not too bad. Not too bad. On the sand. Different gobies and things. Very nice.
Okay. Thank you.
Excellent.
Isn't that amazing? The world's foremost coral sea with 1,300 types of fish? Now it should be obvious why the divers of the world call this the Miracle Sea. What is the reason that this miraculous spectacle can be seen at Raja Ampat? The answer to that mystery is deeply interwoven with the history of the Earth. This environmental NGO has been studying the sea since back in 2001. They've already made many exciting discoveries. This walking shark was recognized as a new species in 2006. Very unusual fish such as this inhabit these amazing waters. In fact, the formation of this sea is closely connected with the global continental drift. This is what the Earth looked like 55 million years ago. India was still separated from Asia, and the island of New Guinea was still far south of the equator. After this, New Guinea began to drift northward. Misul Island, which is now south of Raja Ampat, drifted to its present location from further south, along with New Guinea. However, Waigeo Island to the north has always been located there in the Pacific Ocean. These two islands have been in their present location since 1 million years ago. both brought unique living creatures with them. As a result, Raja Ampat became a crossroads of life. But there is still one more secret to why this sea is so rich in life. That secret lies under the sea. Doesn't the current seem exceptionally fast? This fast-flowing current is really the secret to the bounty of these waters.
Here we have an example of upwelling. That current is coming up from deep waters, bringing cool, nutrient-rich water onto the reef. This is one of the most biodiverse dive sites in the entire world, more kinds of fishes.
That upwelling current carries up nutrients that had settled down to the bottom of the sea. As a result, there is a lot of plankton near the surface of the sea. And that means a wide variety of fish can thrive here. The miracle sea of Raja Ampat off the coast of Indonesia. The divers take on the challenge of filming the symbol of this rich sea, the giant manta ray.
Slopes around the edges, very shallow slope. Sometimes we can see the mantas cruising this pommy.
It's often possible to see manta rays in these rich waters, even from a boat. They can be seen when they come to eat the plankton at the surface. Giant manta rays have gathered in search of plankton.
If you put your ear under the water, mm-hmm. hold your breath, and you mm-hmm. hear the crackling sound.
Really?
Mm-hmm. No, that's the, because the zooplankton is like small shrimp.
Uh-huh.
Very, very small shrimp, yeah.
Uh-huh.
And they've got pincers. So if you listen, try it. Listen.
Really?
Mm-hmm. You can hear the...
It's the sound of the sea. These plankton are the source of life for the giant manta rays. There is one other very special manta ray that they really want to film this time. It's unusual because it's completely black on the upper and lower body, the black manta ray. They're rarely seen, but do appear in these waters sometimes.
Being black both above and below makes them really attractive. I think so.
Now they head off to a place where black manta rays are sometimes seen. The diving guide suddenly sees a manta ray. It's probably eating plankton at the surface of the sea. The cameraman takes his time while slowly moving closer to the manta ray. It's a very large one, with a span of 4 meters. The number of manta rays increases. 3 of them calmly glide closer to our camera. However, all of these are white underneath. That's when it appeared. A manta ray approaches from the distance. Look carefully. It's a black manta ray. But the black manta ray changes direction, which is so disappointing. In the end, the divers' air tanks ran out on this day, and they weren't able to get closer shots.
The black manta ray seems to be more cautious than regular manta rays. The regular ones generally approach directly from the front, but a black manta ray at the surface is very cautious, turning away while still 5 meters from us.
After that, the weather suddenly turns bad. Due to a passing low pressure front, it begins to rain heavily. Will they be able to film a black manta ray from up close? Last day of shooting. The skies are blue once again. This really is their last chance to film a black manta ray. But they have only enough time for one final dive, about 1 hour. A single manta ray appears in the distance. Unfortunately, the visibility is not good, and it can't clearly be seen. The black manta ray everyone had hoped for. The cameraman slowly swims closer to it. However, it turns away just before our camera. We're still not able to get an overall shot. Finally, the air tanks are empty. Nothing more can be done. Then the cameraman did something unbelievable. He'll give it one last try using the remaining air in someone else's tank. Change. 70 bar is enough for a 15-minute dive. He frantically returns to the sea. Fortunately for the film crew, the black manta ray is still nearby. And what's more, now there are three of them. But like before, they won't come near. That's when it happened. The biggest manta ray so far approaches. It has a span of 5 meters. Then our luck finally changed. At last, we got the shot that we had tried so long and hard to get. Just below the equator in Indonesia, Raja Ampat, where a life-giving sea awaits, supporting the world's most amazing coral sea and the fish that live in it.